freshmen come in, but it's going to be a thin team. You know, they lost Cam Newton, Heisman Trophy winner. They lost Nick Fairley, you know, Lombardi Award winner, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. You know, they lost four starting offensive linemen, two of their three linebackers, just people from all over the field on both sides of the ball. And it really is. It's going to be an uphill battle this spring to, you know, not only find those starters, but even to find depth behind them with just kind of the number of players they have.
Well, David, you know, the main focus, obviously, on any football team is the quarterback position. And Cam Newton, whoever might be the replacement for Cam Newton this year, has humongous shoes to fill, no doubt about it. But Auburn fans have definitely got to realize that Cam Newtons don't come around every year, and he's likely, by all stretches, by Todd McShay or Mel Kiper, back and forth, maybe the first overall pick in the NFL draft. So you don't replace him. You just hope you can get a guy in there that's comparable and that can get the job done. And right now it's Barrett Trotter and Clint Mosley. What are you seeing? What are you hearing? And this is an all-out quarterback battle, and that's probably going to go into fall camp.
Yeah, that wouldn't surprise me. I mean, from everything we hear, they're sharing, you know, first-team reps pretty evenly. I think how they do it is they split up their days. So, like, you know, Barrett will be on first-team offense Monday, and then Clint will be on Tuesday and all that, or, I mean, Wednesday or whatever, and all that stuff. And, you know, they're both fairly similar style quarterbacks for their – you know, they're fairly mobile, but not, of course, not nearly as mobile as Cam Newton. You know, they've got pretty good arms. And I think Malzahn is looking at them to be sort of kind of a Chris Todd game manager type of quarterback in the offense. You know, it wouldn't surprise me if there was more of a, you know, halfback running game presence this year, just because you're not going to have a quarterback that's going to run for 1,500 yards. But, you know, Gus Malzahn's had a very, very good track record in college of taking new quarterbacks and making them good, you know, both at Arkansas and Tulsa and Auburn. So, I mean, if one of those two can produce a Chris Todd-like season from 2009, I think he'd be pretty happy.
Well, David, and it sounds like in the past scrimmage, the defense really stepped up and took it to the offense, and a number of new linebackers will get a lot of playing time this year. What do you think in the linebacking core? Who are some names that we'll be seeing a lot more of this year?
Well, you got Darren Bates, who's the one starting holdover. He's going to be a strong side. And then at weak side, you've got a couple guys who started a little bit last year, El Toro Freeman and Jonathan Evans. And then kind of pushing them is going to be a redshirt freshman, Ladarius Owens, who sat out last year, you know, obviously kind of just putting on weight and getting used to the college game and stuff like that. And we've heard good things about him this spring. He's from Bessemer City up near Birmingham. And then in the middle, Jake Holland, he spelled Josh Bynes as a true freshman last year. So he's got a pretty good grip on the starting role there in the middle. And then beyond him, there's not much. I mean, there's guys who really haven't been tested yet, like Jawar White, who sat out all of last year, and Harris Gaston, who's kind of played sparingly over his first 2 years on campus. And then, you know, obviously you're going to have to add the freshmen to the equation when they get there. But right now, linebacker, like most places, looking kind of thin.
We got David Morrison on the phone with us, the beat writer, the Auburn beat writer for the Auburn Opelika News. David, talk about El Toro Freeman just a second. It seems like in every blog and every write-up, El Toro doesn't seem to get mentioned. And this was a guy that a lot of us felt like going into spring with a limited number of players that we'd be hearing a lot out of. And it just seems like, for whatever reason, El Toro continues to be passed over. And I know he's gotten some reps at middle linebacker as well with Jake Holland. And, you know, what's the deal there, David? What are you seeing? What are you hearing about El Toro? Because this is a guy, when he got on the field last year, three times that he started, he led Auburn in tackles in those games. And he had a heck of an Alabama game and was the second leading tackler on the team in that Iron Bowl. Talk about El Toro and where do you see his role?
Yeah, I mean, I think the thing that's troubling coaches, you know, about El Toro is just consistency. You know, like you said, he had a great Iron Bowl. He had a great, you know, couple games filling in for Craig Stevens at the beginning of the year last year. But I think, you know, he's got more of an upside than you know, Jonathan Evans at that other outside linebacker spot. But Jonathan Evans is more consistent than El Toro. Like, El Toro will, you know, overrun running plays and be out of position and stuff like that, and kind of plays that make you scratch your head a little bit and wonder if he, you know, knows the playbook. But when he does make good plays and when he is in position, he's spectacular. And I think that's just the main concern with the coaches right now, is getting that consistency. I mean, he's still definitely in the mix for that outside linebacker spot, and then he he'd be a pretty capable fill-in behind any of the linebacker spots, I think, with his, with both his experience and, you know, his upside.
Well, David, real quick, before we move into something else, A-Day this weekend. You know, A-Days are good for fans, but you really don't see a lot. Do you expect to see very much out of the offense at all, really? It's probably with the depleted numbers, it's going to be hard to get a good look at this Auburn team.
Yeah, well, I mean, we're not expecting to see – the team that we see Saturday, really, we don't expect it to look anything like that come September. You know, I think Clint Mosley said it pretty well, you know, yesterday. He was talking about how he doesn't really play the game for the fans. He plays it for Gus Malzahn because he's going to be the one that's watching the closest. And, you know, the quarterback race isn't going to be won or lost on Saturday, but it could go a long way towards going into summer camp. But – 8 days is the time for, you know, fans to see football again, get a little bit excited, and get some of the walk-ons to maybe shine for the one and only time they can. But we're not going to see much of what the team's actually going to look like, probably.
David, let's talk about baseball just a little bit before we let you go. And for those of us who have maybe not seen quite as much out of this Auburn team this year, what are you seeing? It seems like this past weekend against Kentucky played much better, but Vandy continues to take it to each and every one of us after they sweep Alabama this past weekend. What do you think about the new Auburn team?
Well, Kentucky playing them was kind of a cure-all because Auburn was really floundering, you know, against Vanderbilt, which wasn't that much of a surprise. But then against Mississippi State, they didn't really show up either the weekend before, which was a surprise. But they got back on track a little bit against Kentucky. Some of their started going again. Kevin Patterson, Tony Caldwell, Casey McElroy all had really good weekends. The thing that they still got to worry about is pitching. They only have, I think, probably one consistent starter right now, and that's Derek Varnador, who's been doing it all year. Other than that, John Luke Jacobs has been coming on fairly strong lately, but he hasn't lasted more than 5 2/3, and then you turn it over to the bullpen, which has also been shaky. So they're going to need to find some arms down the stretch if they're going to, you know, try to make a run like they did last year.
David, moving out of baseball, and the last thing we'll discuss, the Brent Callaway story that has come out over the past 2 weeks. Jeffrey Lee, an Auburn blogger and part of AuburnSports.com, coming out with some serious allegations against Alabama and the recruitment of Brent Callaway. And, you know, a lot of times stories are hearsay until names are dropped. And there's a Darren Woodruff guy that's been named here now. Coach Goodwin, the coach at Russellville at the time, Brent Callaway was there. Now at Homewood, a lot of quotes coming out on him. What are you guys hearing? Is there legs to this thing? Is this just the beginning? Is this story dying now? What's the mood?
Well, it just right now at this stage, it's in. It just seems like a lot of kind of posturing from both sides. Like, I don't think, you know, Alabama already sent their own investigators to Russellville, and they found nothing. And there hasn't been really any hard evidence produced yet against Alabama. There's been some people saying some not very flattering things, but that's enough to, you know, launch a full-scale NCAA investigation, I don't think. So, I mean, unless that smoking gun comes here in the near future, I think this thing's pretty much wrapping up.
Well, it'll be interesting to see, and it might be, David, and we'll stay tuned to see what does happen. But, David, we appreciate you taking some time out to be part of the program tonight.
All right. Thanks for having me, guys.